2.7 FM and 820 AM as he delivers game changers in Metro RVA. On the Mic with Mike showcases how business can help make society better. He discusses tech, culture, innovation, best business practices, and highlighting area nonprofits. Join Mike at 1 p.m. Monday through Friday, because it is the place where the best and brightest come to chat.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to On the Mic with Mike. It is the leading daily social business enterprise show in the Richmond area. I'm your host, Mike King, and I appreciate you being here with me. Had a little technical difficulties there. I'm your host, and I appreciate you being here with me. The views expressed here in mind have no connection to, support of, or agreement with any other host, information, or ads on the station. I don't work for the station. My program just airs here on a daily basis, and I'm appreciative of that. So, ladies and gentlemen, joining us, as always, on the Wheels of Steel is my man, Al Green, and we can be reached by calling 804-778-8888. On the Mic with Mike, we highlight partnerships, people, social enterprise, as well as issues of the day. We touch on them every so often, but we just like to keep you informed. So on the Mic with Mike, we highlight partnerships, as I said, people, organizations, people out there in the community trying to do things and make things better for you. The program, as I said, on the Mic with Mike, 1 to 5 daily, 1 to 3 daily, WJFN Radio, 100.5, 92.7, 820 AM. To get more information about the program, you can go to On the Mic with Mike, RVA, on Facebook. We'd like to thank our show sponsor, Tom Childry, the credit card guy. Tom Childry, he's been helping organizations with the credit card merchant services for more than 25 years. He's an expert in the field. Make sure you touch base with Tom Childry. He can help you streamline processes and come up with creative solutions to help you out there. Tom Childry can be reached by calling 804-503-8472. He also does a lot of work in the community. Ladies and gentlemen, along the way, we have to pay bills around here. The microphone isn't free. I always say that. So, you know, take a listen to our sponsors and advertisers as they are, you know, they have some outstanding products and services and they help us stay on the air. So appreciate that. All right, ladies and gentlemen, the program today is an outstanding one. We're going to start off. We have Paul Cooper from Retro Hospitality. He's going to talk about the hospitality industry and some of the creative things that they're doing there. Jerome Olivier is he's starting out his business here. He's an electrician. So he's finding some ways to be able to help you find the help that you need from an electrical standpoint. He's out there really trying to grow his business. We're going to talk about the ideas that he has. We're going to talk to, so it's Thursday. You know what that means? Heather Marie speaks. She's here speaking. She brought along her crew. She brought along some people that had a great conversation today. She brought along Leah Coleman, as well as she brought along, okay. Stevens. Oh, okay. Ladies and gentlemen, that's what happens. It's a senior moment there. Lou Stevens. That's who it is. She's bringing along Lou Stevens as well. And then we're going to follow up with my man, Sergeant First Class Castillo. He's an Army recruiter, and he's real creative in the ways he's talking to people about the military. I spent my time in. I love the military. I love the Army. He's going to talk about what he's doing out there. But up first, we have Paul Cooper. Paul, welcome to the program, sir.
Hey, Mike, thanks.
Alrighty, so we talk a little bit about, you hear what we talk about business, how things work. Give us an idea who Retro is, your journey, and then we'll go into some of the questions that I had because I found your journey interesting.
Yeah, thanks. It's great to join you. Wish I was there in person with you.
We understand.
Actually out here in Charlottesville on a project. But Retro Hospitality, it's a company that I started about a little over 9 years ago, and we're based in Richmond. I've been in Richmond for a little over 15 years now, and we have a small little office on Broad across from Jackson Ward. And We provide some services for in the hotel industry, hospitality industry. We do a lot of work with in a consulting capacity to help entrepreneurs that are interested in getting into hotels and restaurants and event facilities, and we help guide them through the process and walk them through and provide a lot of support when it's, whether it's helping them assemble a property and provide some guidance when it comes to kind of how the deal should be structured and how we can get the property moving and making an impact in the local community. And we also do a good amount of management. So we do a lot of day-to-day management of hospitality projects, and I've been blessed to have the opportunity to work with some great ones. And we work throughout the entire state, and so I'm constantly back and forth between downtown Richmond and our partners there at the Cork Hotel in Richmond and throughout the Commonwealth. So we're got a great team, a lot of folks who are very, very experienced and have been very, very well accomplished folks in their own right, whether it's in marketing or sales or operations or accounting and human resources. And so we get to work with some really great folks and get to have some fun along the way.
Ladies and gentlemen, the voice you're listening to is Paul Cooper of Retro Hospitality. Let me ask you, when it seems like you've carved out a niche there, can you talk to people about finding a niche for you? Because it's the hospitality industry, but you also found other lanes to be successful. Talk a little bit about how you came to that point to be that for these facilities.
Yeah, it is a niche. I mean, we're in a very, very competitive space. Hotel management, hospitality management, there's a lot of folks, but we decided, and I decided a long time ago that, and long time meaning maybe like the last 15 years, that my focus was going to be primarily on the smaller boutique inns where it's really a personalized experience, personalized service. There's a lot of kind of immersion into the project and being present. So being on and engaged with our owners and developers, it's very important that we help communicate what the goals are and how to get to those goals and show them a path and help actually do it, not just tell them how to do it, but actually physically do it with them and build the team around them. So, you know, with a lot of historic adaptive reuse projects, we've really carved out a space as probably the leading hotel management and advisory company in the state of Virginia that works with historic buildings and the preservation of historic buildings and getting projects actually done that are influential in the community. And so that was a niche that we carved out. And again, we've been a very fortunate company, smaller, but that allows us to be really, really engaged in the projects. And by working with some great developers and supportive clients and teams, we've benefited from a lot of word of mouth referrals and advertising. So we're really, really selective of who we get involved with and how we feel we can make a change on the property. So it's a small, very labor intensive, but very specialized service. And we do that again for event spaces, restaurants, hotels, boutique hotels, and now we're I'm out here, and I apologize if you can hear some banging in the background, but we are still finishing up construction on a food hall called the Dairy Market in Charlottesville, and again, it's a destination experience that involves a lot of great small businesses that come under one roof and provide some great food and great experiences, and we get to work with them and help promote their businesses. So that's a lot of fun.
When we hear the banging, that's called making money.
that's
for sure. Hey, let me ask you. So you work with boutique hotels. What's the challenges when you have like a Quirk or those, and then compared to the larger chains? Because it seems like Quirk, they do an outstanding job of being part of the community. I mean, totally being immersed in the community. The other larger, like the chains, they probably are doing that, but they don't have like the feet or, boots on the ground and the commitment. Talk a little bit about what that means to you when you're talking to, like, hotel owners who are localized.
Yeah, I mean, it's a different It's a different business model for sure. I think that the folks that we get to work with in our approach is, again, it's a very entrepreneurial approach. So we can be flexible, we can make decisions, and we can move according to what we're reading in the marketplace and what's important to the customers. We don't have those layers of maybe a little bit more bureaucracy and structure to it. We create our own structure, and then we customize it to each individual location. And it's the key ingredient is always that we focus in on that makes these hotels successful is to be local. And that's maybe a cliche for some, but it really is about before we open a hotel or even at the inception of thinking about a hotel, is that we're already building community alignments and aligning ourselves with others that we feel are on share the same what's important to them, the key values and when where our brands align. So we do a lot of work just engaging the community and involving other businesses that can be that we can be additive to, and they can be additive to our hotel. So we don't have the traditional more of a traditional critical path and structure on the opening. We really build it as we go. We get involved very, very early on in projects, and that helps them be successful. But with Quirk, just like our other properties, we're really promoting the destination. We're promoting all of the small businesses and why people want to come to, for instance, choosing Richmond. Why would they want to come to Richmond compared to wherever else that they can go? And when they get here, it's our job to create that authentic experience and have them experience all of the area. We don't want them sitting necessarily sitting in our lobby all the time. And we love, the spending money and drinking and eating and staying in our beautiful hotel rooms and buying art in our gallery. But we want them to get out in the community. We want them to experience it so that they say, wow, I've got to come back to this beautiful city. I've got to, I've got to try this next small restaurant or I've got to get out and experience, the Capitol Trail, or I've got to hit all the great art museums. And so we just want to continue to create the reason why it's important for them to continue to spend their money and their time in Richmond, Virginia.
Let me ask, so when we look at, we've talked to Jack Barry and we talked to Eric Terry about tourism, bringing dollars in. You're out there talking to people. What's the draw that you hear about Richmond?
I think Richmond has done a fantastic job in evolving. When I moved and as an outsider 15 years ago, I found that there was a buzz within the community. There was more of an altruistic approach of everyone trying to help everyone out. And there's been a lot of folks who just are trying to make others successful. And I think, a lot of the assets you look at, certainly geography and we've got the benefit of being able to be at the beach in 2 hours and the city and the mountains all in 2 hours. And there's that geographic draw, and we're definitely at the crossroads. But I think, the entrepreneurial, small business, the restaurants and the culinary scene that have popped in our city. And I think quite dynamically over the last, call it 7-8 years, there's been a lot of great development projects. It's becoming certainly a place for young professionals to move to. And so we're seeing the proliferation of a lot of, apartments and housing is still doing really well. So I think that there's some key amenities and assets. You've got the James River, obviously, and outdoor recreation, and the Virginia Capitol Trail, which is, such a great experience, and even more so now with COVID and getting out on a bike or running or walking with your kids. So there's a lot to love about Richmond.
The Virginia Capitol Trail was on with us last week, and that's a great organization and the things that they're providing. So you're out in Charlottesville now. What's the difference, would you say? But and I came from a college town before I came to Richmond. We were at State College, home of Penn State. What's the difference from a hotel standpoint that you look at with doing business in like a Charlottesville?
I think that there, we do as a group, and I get to work and with with the team, with the UCROP team and the Bank Street advisors and folks in helping build the Cork brand. So, you know, was involved there in Richmond. And then when I, part of my job with on the Corks is not only kind of helping out the day-to-day management team, but it's also looking at potential sites that we would love to okay. be in. And I went all around kind of the East Coast, and then I came back to Charlottesville, and I was part of the team that helped with the site selection. And we love university towns. We like the energy. We like, you know, the fact that, you know, universities aren't going anywhere.
No, they're not.
We hope, right? So it provides a little bit of a basis that we know that for us as the business will be there, and it's usually an engaged and diverse community of different folks and people who and then also people who have a strong attachment to the university that they may have, you know, graduated from, whether it's, you know, in Richmond, VCU and in Richmond or out here at UVA. So the you know, we love the vibrancy, the energy, we love the kind of creatives, you know, the creatives that kind of circulate around in university towns. But as far as, you know, the difference, you know, there's a lot of, I call it almost, I may get in trouble out here in Charlottesville, but I think there's some Richmond envy, if you will. I think that Charlottesville looks at Richmond and sees the culinary scene and how that's developed and has made it a destination. And there's certainly some fantastic restaurants, and we're getting ready to open this food hall, this Dairy Market food hall, which has some phenomenal restaurateurs. And so I think that there's still that they're looking back at Richmond going, how did you guys,
I can imagine,
pull it off. So yeah, it's fun, but there's a lot of just cross pollination between developers from Richmond who have come out to Charlottesville developers who have come into, you know, into Richmond. There's, you know, small businesses that have a stake in Charlottesville, like Star Hill is our anchor tenant here at the Dairy Market. And, you know, with them opening the location there in Scott's Addition, and they're a brand and a known entity out here in Charlottesville. But there's a lot of folks who would just, you know, the art community, we've seen a lot of folks who you know, artists that we've been able to work with in Richmond that want to come out to Charlottesville and vice versa. So, yeah, it's a good kind of collaborative opportunity for us. And it's only an hour up the road, so you get a different experience.
That's the difference. So when we lived 10 years in State College, so, and they don't call it Happy Valley for no reason. It's a great place to live, but it's 100 miles to anywhere. So you don't have that envy of a town that has some things going on. That was the destination. So I can sort of understand that. One last question that I have. So I know Cork and the other places now have all the rooftop things going on, and those are draws for people. Sometimes do they ever become a distraction? And the reason that I'm asking, so I'm from Philadelphia, and there were sometime hotel, restaurant, bars that became so popular that they became a distraction to the hotel, because that was the reason that everyone came, and I think it became part of a problem. Dude, is that in the industry?
I definitely have heard that in the sense of some of our friends there in Richmond. Some of the competitive hotels have had some challenges with the rooftop taking over and being a distraction to the hotel and to its guests. But for us, we try and curate a certain experience. It's, you know, it's pretty relaxing. We're not looking at jamming, you know, a couple hundred people and you know, people are you know, a little bit out of control, I guess you could say, sometimes with booze, right? But no, I think it's, you know, it's the way we see it, it's additive, and it has to feel like it's not forced. It's part of the overall hotel. And the way that we're a very welcoming brand with the Corks, and very, very inclusive. And when Ted Ucrop and the team and I sat down before he opened it, and he said, listen, nothing would make me happier than to walk in the lobby, and let's create a lobby where people can eat and drink and communicate and meet each other from, whether they're from Richmond, you know, they're a resident of Jackson Ward, or they're a student at VCU, or they're a financier from New York City or family from Charlotte, North Carolina, that they could all kind of sit together and learn and have fun and enjoy the time together. And so ours are, I think they're a little bit more thought out, where it's not.
Okay.
Yeah.
All righty. So, Paul, let people know how they could find you.
Yeah, so retrohospitality.com is the company. You'll see some of our properties that are on there, and I'm on LinkedIn quite a bit. There's social media handles for our Instagram and Facebook, and yeah, you'll find me somewhere between downtown Richmond and the western part of the state. So,
thanks for coming up. When I posted that you were going on, people said, "Hey, he's going to be great. He's an expert."
That's very nice and humbling to hear. So thank you so much.
Cool. Appreciate it. Thanks, Dale. Ladies and gentlemen, Paul Cooper of Retro Hospitality. I'd like to thank him. We got to go away and take a break. On the other side, we're going to have Jerome Olivier of JP Electrical. He's going to be talking about his journey as an entrepreneur.
Hi, I'm Tom Childry, the credit card guy with Beyond. I believe it should not be confusing or expensive for your business to accept credit cards. As a social enterprise business advocate, my mission gets you paid faster with fair rates, helping your business grow. We can be contacted at area code 804-503-8472, 804-503-8472, or at getbeyond.com. Again, I'm Tom Childry, the credit card guy. Quick, easy collect. We make it easier than you expect.
Hi, Chef Michelle here of Mama Show Cafe, home of the Soul Rolls, located at 10811 Hull Street Road. Give us a call at 804-912-1644 or order online at mamashelf.com. Ask about our off-site catering options as well as our online ordering through Grubhub, Uber Eats, and DoorDash. Follow us on all social media at Mama Shelf Cafe. That's Mama Shelf, Soul, south of the James. Mention Mike on the mic and get a free dessert on us. Special rules apply.
Chris Chip here with Focus Floors, and we are offering a free upgrade in any Bona water-based poly for any job that gets put on our schedule. You can reach us at focushardwoodflooring.com or just check us out on Facebook or Instagram. Facebook, Focus Floors 804, Instagram 804s. Thank you.
Hey everyone, it's Heather Marie Van Cleve with Heather Marie Speaks, and I'm on the mic with Mike on WJFN Radio Thursdays from 2 to 2:30 p.m., bringing encouragement, education, and empowerment for mental health awareness with a little bit of fashion infused. Join me every Thursday from 2 to 2:30. I'll see you then.
When Heather Marie speaks, you should be listening on the mic with Mike, weekdays 1 to 3 on WJFN 92.7 and 100.5 FM.
Hanley Watches is the must-have, stylish, comfortable, and versatile timepiece for the person who values quality. Hanley offers sophisticated, modern designs that inspires confidence and generates conversation. Contact us today for the On the Mic with Mike promo. Hanley Watches is the official timepiece of Mike King Biz and On the Mic with Mike. Connect with us at HanleyWatches.com today.
H-A-N-D-L-E-Y, HanleyWatches.com.
Oh, hello. I'm Louise Keaton from the Whistle Stop Theater Company. You're listening to On the Mic with Mike.
Every day.
At 1 p.m. Cheers.
Mike King isn't a businessman. He's a businessman with his own talk show. On the Mic with Mike, the best business radio program in the game.
Hi, Chef Michelle here of Mama Show Cafe, home of the Soul Rolls, located at 10811 Hull Street Road. Give us a call at 804-912-1644 or order online at mamashelf.com. Ask about our off-site catering options as well as our online ordering through Grubhub, Uber Eats, and DoorDash. Follow us on all social media at Mama Shelf Cafe. That's Mama Shelf, Soul, south of the James. Mention Mike on the mic and get a free dessert on us. Special rules apply.
Ponder this. One of the most frightening things I remember as a child was the thought that I might accidentally remove a tag from my pillow. Remember the warning? Do not remove under penalty of law. The thought of being put in jail for removing the tag would keep me up at night. This begs the question, what keeps you up at night? Losing sleep because of our worries takes valuable time away from good sleep needed to function on all cylinders in the next day. How do you stop your thought-induced insomnia? Here's a recipe you might try. First, say a prayer to the Lord like, God, help me stop worrying and start sleeping. Next, tell yourself that worrying produces no results. In fact, worrying often begets more worrying. Finally, tell yourself you will deal with whatever is weighing you down in the morning. Three easy steps to a restful sleep. Calling on Almighty God to help with problems big and small is the Lord's specialty. As he told us in Jeremiah, call on me and I will answer you, and I will tell you great and mighty things which you do not know. Try this recipe for sleep, but whatever you do, don't remove the tag from your pillow. I'm Susie Kelly, and I am passionately Catholic.
Welcome to the SBA Weekly Business Tip. I'm Martin Short with the U.S. Small Business Administration, Virginia Richmond District Office. There are primarily four ways to fund your business. One way is crowdfunding. Crowdfunding raises funds from many people. Crowdfunders aren't technically investors because they don't receive a shared ownership in the business. Crowdfunding is popular because it's a very low risk for business owners. Crowdfunding platforms are different. Read the fine print and understand all the obligations. To learn more, visit us at sba.gov/va. We're here to help you start, grow, expand, or recover.
Does your home need a makeover? If so, refresh with quality with LA Labor and Painting, LLC. They make your home sparkle and be the envy of the community. They are masters at interior and exterior painting, drywall. They clean decks. They landscape and remove items you wish were gone. The bottom line is, they refresh with quality, provide professional service, and follow all guidelines regarding COVID-19. Call today to make your home sparkle. You can reach LA Labor by calling 804-972-8014. Call today for the On the Mic with Mike discount. When you mention the program, you'll receive 20% off of the beautification of your most prized possession. Call LA Labor and Painting today at 804-972-8014.
Thank you, attorneys Justin Lauder and Chris Gatewood at Threshold Counsel PC for sponsoring this program. They offer startup, business, and intellectual property services for innovative and growing organizations. You can find them online at threshold.cc.
Are you tired of dating online? Bloom Matchmaking offers a safe and effective alternative. Every match is vetted and background checked. Bloom Matchmaking offers a personalized experience just for you. Check us out at bloommatchmaking.com or give us a call at 804-205-5063. Let Bloom take the stress out of dating. Mention On the Mic with Mike and receive 20% off. That number again is 804-205-5063. Bloom Matchmaking, where love grows.
Before and after the salon has been active in the Richmond, Virginia community, providing hair styling services for over 10 years. Before and After is located in downtown Richmond at 1917 West Carey Street. Specializing in weaves, extensions, and growing healthy hair, Before and After provides a full suite of hair care services. Expert stylists Michelle Smith and Alicia Clark are well trained to meet your styling needs at Before and After the salon.
Hi, Chef Michelle here of Mama Chef Cafe, home of the Soul Rolls, located at 10811 Hull Street Road. Give us a call at 804-912-1644 or order online at mamachef.com. Ask about our off-site catering options as well as our online ordering through Grubhub, Uber Eats, and DoorDash. Follow us on all social media at Mama Chef Cafe. That's Mama Chef's, Soul South of the James. Mention Mike on the Mic and get a free dessert on us. Special rules apply.
My name is Isabella, and you're listening to Mike King Biz Hubby. That's my skin.
So your wife listening?
Jay Paul. Yep, Jay Paul.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back on the Mic with Mike. It is the premier business show in the area. I'm host Mike King. We're here with you daily, 1 to 3 p.m. on WJFN Radio, 100.5, 92.7, 820 a.m. This is the place where the game changers come to talk. At the top of the hour, we have Heather Marie Speaks. But with us now joining the program is Jerome Olivier of J. Paul Electric. Hello, welcome to the program, sir.
Thank you, Mike.
All righty. So you had a vision. You want to start a business.
Yes.
You're just starting it. Right off the bat, tell people who you are, what you do, and then we'll go into the business model and some of the philosophy that you have that makes your business different.
Right. So Jerome Olivier, and I'm representing my business, J. Paul Electric. COVID-19 is here, and we know that things are different, and there were some hurdles involved in me starting.
Okay.
Some hiccups, to find peace and to find confidence in providing the service that I provide, I've come to conclude that my hours are from Friday to Sunday. That's pretty much the main difference right now between me and other electrical service companies.
Okay, so from a business model, let's talk about that.
Sure.
You did not want to, and that says something about you personally, you didn't want to advertise and be something that you couldn't give the person who you are. When I said you're the weekend guy who comes in, you're like, no, I'm not the weekend emergency guy. Correct. You want to be the person your business hours are the weekend, the times that you know that you can provide service. Now, do you do residential, commercial? Talk a little bit about what you do.
So right now, I'm mainly focusing on residential, also commercial, not taking on big commercial projects yet. So a lot of it is service work. A lot of it is adding, you know, for additions and wiring for additions, panel swaps, service upgrades. But these are all typical things that you see for an electrician.
Okay. So the electrician, I don't want to blow myself up as the, so we call an electrician.
Right, exactly.
So you had an idea that you wanted to start your company. And what's the step? So people are out there wanting to do things. They want to do something. What's the step that you took to make it happen?
Well, I already had the vision. I already knew what I was doing, where I was heading to.
Okay.
The trick came when COVID came. So, you know, family situation changed, my situation changed, a lot of other people's situations changed. So instead of being, what I found was I was servicing people Monday through Sunday. Mm-hmm. And there was always a hesitation in me. I was not always sure, even though I satisfied all my customers 100%, there was a fear of Joe Schmo taking a day off for our appointment Wednesday at 9 a.m. and then me calling it on a Wednesday, 8 a.m., telling him that I can't make it after all because of the other responsibilities that are that I'm dealing with in my personal life. So I, you know, had to make adjustments. Personally, if I'm not well, I felt like I wasn't at peace. I don't want to give people a false impression, you know. As an electrician, I have learned there's a lot of responsibility that goes into it. Not only electrical installs, but actually dealing with clients and customers.
Okay.
So
faith plays a big part in your world and your life.
It absolutely does.
Okay,
Mike.
Let's talk a little bit about what that means to J. Paul Electric.
So I consider myself a spiritual person, and I guess I'm not really going to go there too much.
Okay.
But at the end of the day, I feel that when I don't have peace in my life, in my personal life, it will affect the rest of my life.
So we had that conversation talking about marketing your business.
Yes.
And so you wanted to make sure everything is in line.
Correct.
Because that would make a stronger business model.
A stronger business model. You know, I'd rather turn down business than fail at your house, not showing up. I'd rather not do it, tell you I cannot do it, then tell you I can and fail.
Okay.
It's all about efficiency.
The time is 1:42. Jerome Olivier, J. Paul Electric is here with us talking about his journey. Now, we connected through Paula Pardell and Synapse.
Yep. That's right, yep.
How'd you get to Synapse, and what does Synapse do for you?
So I owned a small cab company back in the day.
A cab company?
Yes, sir, I did.
So, Al? Never had a cab company. We've had a circus owner. Okay.
And you won't get them now. You won't get them.
That's true.
Right. And that's why I left that business, because I read the letter that Uber wrote to the DMV, and they basically said, F you and your laws, state of Virginia, we're going to do what we want to do. And at that point, I knew as a taxi, you couldn't win. You weren't going to beat Uber. The regulations, laws were on the taxis, but they were not on Uber.
I didn't know we were coming and talking about a taxi cab.
Right.
How do you? Okay.
Go ahead.
How did you get into that business?
I was always a driver. Always a people person. Not to brag on myself, but
that's what you come here for. Okay. You come here to brag on yourself. That's what we do here.
Always have had excellent references.
Okay.
You know, always have had that throughout my career at anything. But what happened was I met a man that had a contract with VCU. It was a multi-million-dollar contract, and he basically showed me how to hustle. And we went out, and I did so many. I was like his apprentice. He was starting his big company. I followed him. We did so many things, and I learned so much. And through that, became encouraged to, you know, and that's where when the taxi ended, I thought to myself, now, don't get me wrong, I was still working, and I even changed my company at that time to a Weekend Warrior Taxi. But then Uber came, and I just let the whole thing go. But I'm entrepreneurial spirited, and I chased, at the age of 36, a electrical license, because I want something else that I can use for myself to provide a service to other people to have my own business, see?
Okay, and how can people find you?
You can look me up. I'm on Facebook. jpaulelectric.com is my website. I am right now in the grand opening stage of my business.
There we go.
So grand opening, thank God for that, because it gives you time to make adjustments. I've just recently changed my name to J. Paul Electric. I feel like that was a godsend. I started out with another name, and I found out somebody else was using that name. Even though I own the rights, I decided to not fight this person over the name. I went with J. Paul. Paul is my middle name. I'm Jerome Paul Olivier. And my grandfather, his name was Paul, and he was an electrician, a dynamite electrician.
So you always had the hustle in you.
I did. You know what? I didn't know how to do it. And when I was taught it, it really expanded my mind. I went to learn a lot of things. So it was in me, but I needed to be educated somewhere.
So you had the hustling. You just need to find the right person to give you the path, you know, the tools to find out what you're hustling at to really make
it. Yes, absolutely.
So it didn't matter whether you were doing hustling with taxi, electrical, just make it in life. Because you're going to work and make it work.
Yeah. You know, one, and this might sound cliche, but one thing that I've found to be so rewarding is when somebody comes with me as a worker of mine, as a helper of mine, and I pay him at the end of the day. And then he looks at me and says, do we have anything for tomorrow? It is just an awesome feeling to be able to, I basically gifted people with a little bit of work in the past before I even started my business. And that was a great feeling because you have nothing, you're sitting at home, and I just blessed you. You worked for it, but you also learned something. And one particular person is now in the trade as an electrician himself. So,
talk a little bit, if you would, about what you just said, what that means to help the next person. What's the vision for J. Paul Electric for, say, 5 years down the road?
The vision is huge, Mike. I'm looking into it right now. I'm looking at hiring, gathering employees. It's not easy. It's not easy. So the fact of the matter is that, and people say it all the time, we can't find enough people that want to use their hands to work, at least not young people. So there's an issue. I'm looking into that issue now. A lot of people kind of frown on the younger people because they don't want to work with their hands. But that's why I say, hold up. let's really take a look at why they don't want to work with their hands. We crawl under houses, you get dirty. Your knuckles get busted, you're going to bleed every day, you're going to get scraped, you're going to get shocked. You're going to do that for this dollar, but your buddy, 18, just like you, is working in an office with AC for this dollar. So, you know, they're saying, I'd rather do this. I'm cleaner, I don't get beat up, and I'm making more money. Where's my future? So I think there's an issue. My plan is to bring people in and show you what the future can be for you. You understand?
I was shocked when you told me that about the shortage of guys in electrical field.
Mm-hmm. There is a shortage. Basically, when I was in school, I was begged to stay and to finish and to get my license. 4 years in a row where they pretty much begged us to continue on the path.
People were dropping out like that, or you didn't?
People dropped out. So I want to say maybe in 2008, people referred to as the bottom falling out.
Mm-hmm.
So in my experience with other electricians, they'll always tell the story of how the bottom fell out. Some of them didn't work for 2 years. Some of them worked sewing in sewing factories for 2 years. You know, they did other things to survive. So during that time, and it's actually happening right now, people are retiring. And so many people retired, and that eliminated businesses in the electrical industry and employees as well. So that's where the shortage actually came. And I'd have to say, I'm also imagining because people weren't coming to the trades anymore, at least not younger people, you know.
That's true. Jerome Olivier, J. Paul Electric is here with us on the mic with Mike, dynamic young business owner. Okay, so it's not just you rolling by yourself. We got to talk about the family and what that means on how you make it. Because when people see a business, it's not just one person.
Correct.
The family's on a journey.
Correct.
And the family's doing up and down, up and down.
That's right.
So the microphone's yours, man. You got to get a shout out.
Okay, well, shout out to my wife, Angela. I love you to death. My beautiful son, Emmanuel. And I'm usually with my son. My wife, obviously, she's a woman, and she says to me, you stay home and take care of the baby, I go to work. That's strange because this is my wife who, she breastfed my son, she was with him, you know, they bonded, and she still decided that I should stay home. We went through that. That was a rough spot.
I can imagine.
Yeah.
Because, you know, when you're with your kids early on, it no matter what you do, that's always going to be there. Those years go by fast, no matter.
Absolutely.
You know, even when you're in the middle of it, it seems like they're never going to be all of the things that you do as a parent. But, you know, congratulations to you on that.
Yeah, thank you very
and
much.
The things that you do. Shout out to you and the missus for making this go. So on the mic with Mike, folks, you're going to hear his commercials. So please, you know, reach out and touch him. That way, you know, he'll give you excellent service. You see what the foundation of his business is about. One last time, let folks know how they can find you.
jpaulelectric.com. You can find me on Facebook. I'm working on the Instagram. But if you find me on jpaulelectric.com, you will see the links, and they will take you to wherever else you in.
All righty. Like to thank him for coming in. One last time, you know, thanks to you for all you do. Looking forward to having you on the program here. The time is 1:50. Ladies and gentlemen, up next, we're going to have Heather Marie speak. She is here with Lee Coleman as well as Lou Stevens. I'm not sure what they're going to be talking about. I'm just happy to be here with you guys and to hear from them. All right, we'll talk to you on the other side. Thanks,
Mike.
Welcome to Miss Girlie's, conveniently located at 4809 Parker Street in the heart of Fulton. We take food back to the basics, just like our grandmother, Girlie Frances Crump, used to do it, the way we've always done it. So grab your family, grab your friends, and come taste a little bit of home. Open for business 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. Tuesday through Saturday.
Hey guys, this is Robin with DB Arcade Commercial Video and Photography. If you need creative visual content for social media or traditional advertising, then we're the team you want working for you. We create custom ROI-driven videos and photography for your business, no matter what products or services you offer. We've worked with local newspapers, gyms, real estate agents, financial advisors, clothing companies, restaurants, and more. For more information, check us out on our website at db-arcade.com.
Does your home need a makeover? If so, refresh with quality with LA Labor and Painting, LLC. They make your home sparkle and be the envy of the community. They are masters at interior and exterior painting, drywall. They clean decks. They landscape and remove items you wish were gone. The bottom line is, they refresh with quality, provide professional service, and follow all guidelines regarding COVID-19. Call today to make your home sparkle. You can reach LA Labor by calling 804-972-8014. Call today for the On the Mic with Mike discount. When you mention the program, you'll receive 20% off of the beautification of your most prized possession. Call LA Labor and Painting today at 804-972-8014.
Are you tired of dating online? Bloom Matchmaking offers a safe and effective alternative. Every match is vetted and background checked. Bloom Matchmaking offers a personalized experience just for you. Check us out at bloommatchmaking.com or give us a call at 804-205-5063. Let Bloom take the stress out of dating. Mention On the Mic with Mike and receive 20% off. That number again is 804-205-5063. Bloom Matchmaking, where love grows.
Hi, I'm Tom Childry, the credit card guy with Beyond. I believe it should not be confusing or expensive for your business to accept credit cards. As a social enterprise business advocate, my mission gets you paid faster with fair rates, helping your business grow. We can be contacted at area code 804-503-8472, 804-503-8472, or at getbeyond.com. Again, I'm Tom Childry, the credit card guy. Quick, easy collect. We make it easier than you expect.
Henley Watches is the must-have, stylish, comfortable, and versatile timepiece for the person who values quality. Henley offers sophisticated, modern designs that inspires confidence and generates conversation. Contact us today for the On the Mic with Mike promo. Henley Watches is the official timepiece of Mike King Biz and On the Mic with Mike. Connect with us at henleywatches.com today.
H-A-N-D-L-E-Y, henleywatches.com.
Does your home need a makeover? If so, refresh with quality with LA Labor and Painting, LLC. They make your home sparkle and be the envy of the community. They are masters at interior and exterior painting, drywall. They clean decks. They landscape and remove items you wish were gone. The bottom line is, they refresh with quality, provide professional service, and follow all guidelines regarding COVID-19. Call today to make your home sparkle. You can reach LA Labor by calling 804-972-8014. Call today for the On the Mic with Mike discount. When you mention the program, you'll receive 20% off of the beautification of your most prized possession. Call LA Labor and Painting today at 804-972-8014.
This is Candace Dion. Make sure you tune into Discussions with Dion every Monday at 2 p.m., where we talk inspiration, motivation, natural health, fitness, and life. You can find me at Dancing with Dion, D-I-O-N, dancingwithdion.com, and Candace Dion on Facebook and Instagram.
Talking about being your best, Discussions with Dion, Mondays on the Mic with Mike, here on WJFN 92.7 and 100.5 FM.
Hey guys, this is Robin with DB Arcade Commercial Video and Photography. If you need creative visual content for social media or traditional advertising, then we're the team you want working for you. We create custom ROI-driven videos and photography for your business, no matter what products or services you offer. We've worked with local newspapers, gyms, real estate agents, financial advisors, clothing companies, restaurants, and more. For more information, check us out on our website at db-arcade.com.
Mike King isn't a businessman, he's a businessman with his own talk show, On the Mic with Mike, the best business radio program in the game.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome back on the mic with Mike. Musical interlude there, we had take five. And so, you know, thank Al Green for the musical selection. Up next at the top of the hour, we got the house, we got, you know, power players in the house. We got Heather Marie Speaks. She brought the crew. She brought Lou Stevens as well as Lee Coleman here. I'm not sure what we're talking about. I'm just happy to be here. That's right, mental health. Okay, and all the cool things going on, Times 159 on the mic with Mike, but it is the time with Heather Marie Speaks. We're going to go away for a second. We'll be back at the top.
Listening to WJFN Goochland, WJFN Chester.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm John Scott. Commissioner Stephen Hahn says today's meeting of the Food and Drug Administration's Vaccine Advisory Panel is an important day for all of America. He hopes it will lead to the beginning of the end of the pandemic. Dr. Hahn says if approved, the American public should have confidence and get vaccinated.
We need to get to herd immunity, and that requires a substantial percentage of Americans to be vaccinated. Mm-hmm. So that's why we've been transparent. It's why we want this public discussion of the data. It's why we've been very careful about the review of the data, and we'll make a very careful decision.
Dr. Hahn appearing on NBC News today. Meanwhile, a new poll finds only about half of Americans are ready to roll up their sleeves and get vaccinated against the coronavirus. Also at townhall.com, Massachusetts' highest court says Governor Charlie Barker didn't overstep his authority with orders to close businesses and limit gatherings to control the spread of the coronavirus. The Supreme Judicial Court rejected a challenge brought on behalf of a group including salon owners, pastors, and a private school in Massachusetts. 17 states have joined Texas in trying to undo President Trump's election loss.
Texas has won the support of 17 other states in its lawsuit, which asks the Supreme Court to throw out the voting results from Georgia, Michigan, Pennsylvania, and Wisconsin. Lawyers for the other states called on the nine justices to hear the Texas lawsuit aimed at helping President Trump stay in office. However, election law experts have said the lawsuit stands little chance of success and lacks legal merit. Greg Clugston, Washington.
The number of people applying for unemployment aid jumped last week to 853,000, the most since September. That's according to the Labor Department. On Wall Street, stocks remain mixed. The Dow is down 89 points, but the NASDAQ is up 51. More on these stories at townhall.com.
If you're drowning in IRS debt and can't afford to pay, then you need to take advantage of special IRS tax programs that are available and free yourself from IRS collection efforts once and for all.
Due to the financial hardship consumers are facing throughout the country, the Internal Revenue Service has made it easier to settle delinquent tax problems. An open phone line has been established by Community Tax for consumers to call and see if they qualify. Take down this number or store it in your cell phone, but call the Community Tax Helpline at 800-461-8937. If you owe back taxes to the IRS and cannot afford to pay them back, or even if you have years of unfiled tax returns, there's no need to fear anymore. But you have to call the Community Tax Helpline today at 800-461-8937 for the help that you need. Don't take on the IRS alone. They can attack your wages, savings, pension, home, and even your Social Security check. Call 800-461-8937 for your free consultation and to see if you qualify. That's 800-461-8937.
DoorDash priced its shares at $102 apiece heading into its stock market debut.
DoorDash began trading Wednesday on the New York Stock Exchange at almost $39 billion under the symbol Dash. The seven-year-old food delivery company passed $3.4 billion with the offering. DoorDash's revenue more than tripled between 2018 and 19. But lockdown orders and the closure of indoor dining have made DoorDash indispensable.
Correspondent Jeremy House. With a chaotic and costly no-deal Brexit only 3 weeks away, gloom settling on both sides of the English Channel. European Union and United Kingdom trade negotiators are facing a Sunday deadline that was set after inconclusive talks on Wednesday. Both sides now fear their drawn-out four-year divorce may well end on bad terms. Breaking news at townhall.com. NASA names 18 astronauts to train for its Artemis moon landing program.
48 years after astronaut Gene Cernan was the last man to walk on the moon, NASA announces plans for a return. 18 astronauts were named Wednesday to train for NASA's Artemis moon landing program. Among them, Shel Lindgren.
There are many times in this job where you have kind of pinch me moments.
Nine of the astronauts named to the Artemis program are women, including Kayla Barron.
We're actually going to build a small space station that's going to orbit the moon, and we can fly Orion to the Gateway and then get on our lander from there.
NASA's aiming to land a man and woman on the moon by 2024. I'm Mike Gracia.
The Naval Academy's midshipmen in Maryland will finish off their fall semester with the Army-Navy football game before heading off on winter break. Classes for the spring semester start on January 19th. More on these stories at townhall.com. I'm John Scott.
Mr. Joyce, sometimes people don't maintain their heating and cooling system.
You wouldn't go a year without changing the battery in your smoke detector, would you?
You would never do that.
Make sure your smoke detector has fresh batteries and call James River Air to make sure your heating and cooling systems are tuned up and ready for duty.
Anytime's a good time for a tune-up.
Plumbing, heating, cooling, electrical, and appliances. James River Air can service all of these systems. We are your whole home service partner. Call or click jamesriverair.com.
Feel the hot new reels and cool cash at Rosie's Gaming Emporium. Are you ready for added excitement, more ways to win, and bigger payouts? Then stop into your favorite Rosie's and check out our all-new machines where jackpot pools start at $100,000. Don't miss the next level of jackpots, new ways to win, and big-time payouts. Only at Rosie's Gaming Emporium.
Stop by and win today, or click rosiesgaming.com for more info. rosiesgaming.com.
Ladies and gentlemen, the President of the United States.
No doubt you've noticed that on the walls are the prints of four men. Men that I consider, in my book, are about the four top Americans of the past. They are Franklin, Washington, Lincoln, and Lee. And anybody who ever tries to put me in any other relationship with respect to General Lee is mistaken.
General Eisenhower was not the only president who admired Lee. Grant, Truman, Roosevelt, and Johnson all held Lee in great esteem. Prime Minister Winston Churchill praised Lee as the noblest American who ever lived. There are some who disagree. Governor Northam, Attorney General Herring, and Mayor Stoney want to remove all public recognition of General Lee. They failed to recognize Lee's greatest achievement in reuniting our nation. Contact your state legislatures. Let them know you strongly object to removal. A country which permits a man like Lee to be demonized is a country in decay. This ad is endorsed by the organization Remember and the Friends of Lee Statue.
For info, click releemonument.com.
Hey, it's Shannon Lilly, and I'll be on the mic with Mike this Friday. Tune into 100.5 and 92.7 FM.
Hey everyone, it's Heather Marie Van Cleve with Heather Marie Speaks, and I'm on the mic with Mike on WJFN Radio Thursdays from 2 to 2:30 p.m., bringing encouragement, education, and empowerment for mental health awareness with a little bit of fashion infused. Join me every Thursday from 2 to 2:30. I'll see you then.
When Heather Marie speaks, you should be listening on the mic with Mike, weekdays 1 to 3 on WJFN 92.7 and 100.5 FM.
Time 207 on the mic with Mike. Just want to read my disclaimer. If you express to your mind, have no connection to, support of, or agreement with Danny as the host, information or ads on the station. I don't work for the station. My program just airs here on a daily basis to bring you the best and brightest of Richmond and sort of surrounding areas. It's 2 on Thursday. So what time does that make it?
It's time for Heather Marie Speaks.
The lady is here, and she's not rolling solo today.
No, I've got
She got the besties. So we're going to let you introduce. You're going to talk about what you're doing, and I'm going to jump in with the questions because
Yeah. All right. So, hey, everybody. Thanks for joining me this week. Today, I have two of my very closest friends with me, Lou Stevens of Lou Stevens Glam Squad and Leah Coleman, who is the rocker and shaker out there in the real estate world. These ladies are both closest to me than anybody else in my circle. And so I wanted to bring them in because today we're going to talk about mental health, friendship, making sure your tribe is good, that we're lifting each other up. And these ladies have seen me go through the ups and downs of life. They know the real Heather, and they are here to confirm that, yes, I am real. This is me.
Because we kind of questioned at a time.
Right?
Al and I did. You know, we were good until we saw you singing.
I know.
And then we were done.
But these
two.
She
does everything perfectly.
Al said, is she a cyborg?
Mm-hmm. No, I am real. I am not an alien from another planet. But these two are able to talk about what they've seen me kind of go through, overcome, thrive in, fail at. You know, it's all about being real. And so with mental health, I always talk about how important it is to make sure you've got a tribe of people that are lifting you up and encouraging you and sharpening you like iron sharpens iron. We talk about that all the time. And so without further ado, we're going to start with Lou Stevens, a.k.a. Lulu. We both met in the wedding industry years ago. I was doing wedding planning as a side hustle, and Lou has always just thrived in the makeup and hair industry. Mm-hmm. So tell everybody what you're doing, how we met. Give a little bit of background on some juice that people might want to hear. Go ahead.
So it's been 30 years that I've had the business doing hair and makeup for weddings. Can't believe that it's been that long. But the most special thing about meeting you in particular was when you were running the venue.
Yeah.
And, you know, when you're in the wedding industry, just like I'm sure a lot of industries, you go to all kinds of industry events and parties and things. And it was just going to be another one of those. But there was something about when I came out to that particular event that day, and you and I didn't know each other real well before that. But there was definitely something about that day that God spoke to me and said that this was going to be a deep friendship.
Oh,
and
I love that.
Sure enough.
Yeah, we were very surface level friendships before.
Yep.
And people can
and
have that.
And we know
that.
How to do that.
Yeah, and we have that kind of, out there in the real world, people have surface level mm-hmm. friendships. And you have to have that because I've talked about it before, you have confidants in your life. You have confidant friendships that are really true friendships that are with you through thick and thin. And I feel like that's what we are. We're thick sisters mm-hmm. right here. And then you have constituents. And those are people that are like the scaffolding on a building that are there for a short period of time just to see the building go up, maybe to get their own benefit from it, and then they're out.
Mm-hmm.
And in the beginning, we probably had more of the constituent relationship, yep. but we definitely don't now.
No.
We know each other very
well. We got in there deep.
Yeah.
exactly.
And it's important to have that. Yeah. And it's like sisters, soul sisters. Mm-hmm. It's not from the same bloodline, but you've got differences between us. We're similar in some ways, and we're very different in other ways. What did we say years ago? We said you were sassy. And I was classy.
Classy, that's right. I was trying to bring up more of the sass in you.
Yeah.
And you were trying to bring up more of the class in me.
Yep.
There you go.
So what could you tell people out there that are listening, that are that watch me? Because we talk about this all the time. Mm-hmm. I get judged by the outside
yeah.
all the time. And people sometimes out there, haters gonna hate.
Yep.
People want to see that I'm not real.
Yep.
What can you kind of give as far as what you've seen me go through? What can you say about Heather Marie? Go ahead. I give you free reign.
I get to see it all. I got to see it all
yeah.
because I got to stay with you for about 6 weeks,
yeah.
right?
Yeah, you did.
So if I didn't already know the real side of you and the deeper side of you through just having conversations,
yeah.
anytime I came to you when I was having a crisis, you were right there for me. Yeah. And we just had deep conversations. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then coming out and hanging out at your place when I really needed a place to stay until I bought my house, I got to really see who you are 24/7.
Yes, you did.
So,
what did
yeah,
you see?
We were getting a deeper friendship and, you know, all of that, but it was really getting deep by watching you waking up first thing in the morning, putting in your little ponytail on top of your head with no makeup and go out to the farm and take care of the farm.
That's the thing that we were talking about.
Yeah. I mean, that's the yeah. real stuff that other people probably don't get to see, but they're starting to see more of it.
Yeah.
I'm starting to notice you're putting more things out there that are, you know, without all the makeup and all the glam and whatever, so people can see that, which I think is amazing, because you do. You have such a genuine side, and a side that isn't afraid to go out and get dirty and feed the pigs and the chickens
yeah.
and the, you know, whatever.
It's not like Zsa Zsa Gabor with Green Acres, right? It's
no.
I get out.
You're
there
not out
sometimes.
There in an evening gown.
But there is a chandelier and
but
a chicken coop.
There is a chandelier.
And you shall see the bling.
There's some fancy out there. Yeah, that's for sure. So
no,
Lily is chiming in here. Leah and I met when I had my boutique in Midlothian, and I was refinishing furniture. I was still doing the wedding planning out of that boutique as well, but you had called me because there was a piece that your friend had bought. And
yes.
we met through social media. It was just one of those
yes.
connections that you reached out. So tell everybody who you are. You're rock and rolling out there in real estate, how long you've been doing that, and how we know each other.
Well, thank you.
Yes.
That's a mouthful, actually.
I know.
But I'm happy to share because it's not every day that we actually get to talk about some of the things that we do all the
mm-hmm.
time. We just do it.
Yeah.
You know, we show up every day and do it. And so thank you. So, yeah, we met right even as you transitioned from the boutique before
the venue.
you got the venue.
Mm-hmm.
And the way that a lot of my friends have always called on me was like in their in between transitions.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. And like so just like she has a special relationship where she was saying, you know, you're just always there for me when I need you. I'm like the girl that Heather will text in the middle of the night 24/7. So she was with her 24/7 at her house. But I'd be like the friend that's, you know, she's texting in the middle of the night, like, I need you to pray now. Because something's going on and
yeah.
I just can't, you know, shake it. I can't sleep. So we all need those
yeah.
type of relationships. So I think the way that you actually gestured your trust in me with like very big moments in your life that were also private really like touched my heart because,
oh.
you know,
because it was authentic.
It
real.
Really was.
Yeah.
And it was, and I would have been probably a surface level friend if, I mean, when you meet people on social media, you don't necessarily think that you're just going to be like this deep friendship,
yeah.
you know, or sparking some type of deep friendship. But I think that that's another thing. I mean, about like the era that we live in, you know, here we are live on Facebook. It's 24/7.
Mm-hmm.
It's
and on the radio.
It's mm-hmm. actually something that it's a big part of our life now
yeah.
As people. And I think that the first way I reached out to you was I connected through a private message
mm-hmm.
and I'd seen her boutique because my friend said, look, I just bought this like really cute rocking chair at this boutique on Midlothian. And she was like, Leah, I just walked in that store and I just was like, I have to tell my friend Leah. So I have not actually talked to Korea Preston in a very long time. So
oh.
shout out to Korea if
hey,
she
Korea.
Sees. she was the seed of friendship that sparked our friendship for.
So she bought the piece that I had refinished, right, for her nursery or something.
Yes.
Yeah.
Yep. And then when you were in the process of buying that venue that actually Lou had, you know, gotten a deeper friendship connection from attending, I remember us having many conversations about like how you should structure that and just contractual things. And I was just glad that you just could call and brainstorm.
Yeah.
Sometimes we just need a friend to like weigh in on like small things and big things, but I just always found myself on the receiving end of a phone call or a text, like in the small moments and the big ones.
Well,
and
you're so really good at that too. You're so good at being, you're an encourager. You speak life into people. Mm-hmm. You know, there's been times where I've been blessed to be able to be a listening ear to you when you needed to vent about things too. Yep. So our friendship, it goes both ways. We lift each other up. We sharpen each other when we need it. Mm-hmm. We speak truth when we need it too. Sometimes I call you guys the sounding board and say, hey, is something off? Like, am I thinking wrong on this? And then you guys are able to kind of be that sounding board, and we've done it, you know, together back and
perspective.
Forth, which is awesome. Yeah.
Hey, the time's 2:17 on the mic with Mike. It is Heather Marie Speaks, but she's not speaking alone today.
No.
She's brought Lee Coleman and Lou Stevens. Let me jump in for a second.
Yeah, go ahead.
So, Lou, you know, appreciate what you did, you know, for me with my son and all that. So, talk about being the person in the beauty industry, what that, because you are the name that everyone knows, and you put a lot of people on their path. Talk about what that's been like. And on top of that, we also got to talk about your singing career.
Well, it's been an incredible blessing, and I feel like the biggest blessing of being Lou Stevens and, you know, having all the things that I've had has been exactly what you're talking about, like helping your son.
Yeah.
And all of, gosh, it's got to be a few hundred artists that I've helped go on to incredible careers. And that's, for me, the best part. You know, when you get to this point in your life, you're all about the legacy. Mm-hmm. You realize you're not here forever. And the biggest blessing is being able to pass on what was such an incredible blessing to me onto other folks and set them up for success too.
When was it that you realized, hey, this Lou Stevens thing is kind of, I'm like kind of like a big deal, and I'm able to give people a platform?
I mean, that's all God. So even having it worded that way feels uncomfortable.
I know. Well, you know, it's kind of like, I mean,
like that's all God. And so there was definitely a point when my business was just me, and it all shifted. And for me, it was definitely God speaking to me. And I didn't know why and I didn't know what, but he actually told me to read a book that was about being a leader for young women. And up until then, there was no part of my life that represented being a leader for young women. And so I read it, and I'm like, you must have something big for me. I could feel he had something big for me. And then that ended up being right around the corner, growing my business and taking in so many young artists. I mean, artists that sometimes are so green they haven't even picked up a curling iron before, and completely training them. And now I get to see all over social media tons and tons of these young people. I want to say young women, but Michael's not a woman.
And so you're dealing with them, and then you see what they've grown into, and you see that you were there at the beginning.
Yeah.
It really says something about, like you said, leaving a legacy.
Yes.
What does Richmond look like now compared to back in those days from the business standpoint?
30 years.
From 30 years ago? Oh, my gosh. 30 years ago. There were no cell phones, so on a very practical level, there was no GPS. So for me, you know, business-wise or whatever, to be able to grow the business, I couldn't even take pictures of my clients and have them and save them for reference for the wedding day when I did their previews and stuff like that. I mean, that's a simple thing that's changed. No social media. I remember when Facebook first started, and it was all geared towards friendship, and I knew immediately that was a platform for doing hair and makeup and having clients book me. Well, that was novel because I've been doing this so long that it was a brand new thing.
True.
Before Facebook existed. So those have all been changes. Because it was like 15 years that it was just me doing what I did. And when competition came in, I would say that was the biggest thing that kind of scared me. But then I realized real quick it wasn't scary at all, because the reason there was more competition is because there were more people out there hiring people to do hair and makeup for their
weddings. Gotcha. Okay.
So as the competition grew, guess what? So did the huge market, mm-hmm. you know, to be able to...
The demand,
mm-hmm. exactly. And so I stopped seeing other artists as my competition. But like, isn't this great? Because there are so many weddings that are hiring people for hair and makeup now that we all get to work. And the industry gets even more
true.
Popular.
Time 2:21, that is the voice listening to. That was Lou Stevens there. Lee. So...
Leah, I'm sorry. Or Lee.
We're friends.
Or Lee.
I meet you standing in the Urban Hang Suite.
Oh my gosh.
Yeah.
I feel like I met you.
You said you're Michael's dad.
Yeah.
You know what? That's what, you know, I'm like king.
There you go.
But all of a sudden,
is that. Isn't he?
Yes.
Well, yeah, but he's Michael.
Okay.
And you know, my mom would like me to be a Michael, but, you know, I stopped being Michael a long time ago.
And so you go by Mike.
Mike King.
And are you senior or junior at all?
Senior, but senior. I'm just Mike King.
Okay.
And so I'm in the and you say you're, and but I knew you from the women's group that you rock and roll with.
Lost Faith.
Yes.
Yeah.
I have had so much fun in this city in the past couple of years, especially because there was an opportunity to help lead Boss Babes RVA, which is a private Facebook group. When I started helping in 2018, the end of 2018, so it's a little over a year now because it was the end of 2018. We're at the end of 2020, so it's 2 years now. Under the founder, Christine Greenberg, she was ready to transition life with, you know, with working women having babies. I was actually coming out of... being home for 3 years with my little one. And then when she finally got in preschool, it was a great time to get started in work and career. And I'd had my real estate license since 2010. Always had it, did part-time referrals, just aimed, y'all talk about legacy today. Like, this is a very actually intentional topic mm-hmm. that actually we talk about in our friendship. And when it comes to legacy, they all knew that when I got into real estate and wanted to do more of it. I told them, I said, y'all, I really need to get to be a wife to my husband and family that like really brings value and extra income in. I don't want him to feel the stress because he's a business owner as well.
Wait, you can't just, okay. You just can't drop that and not leave the name. Come on now. We blow people up here. There you go.
Yeah.
Okay.
VA.
Okay, and how can people find him?
Yep, and he's on Facebook and integratedpestva.com. In fact, he has made it so easy for his customers to actually just order and click what they need service for.
Gotcha. Okay.
Residential and commercial, but yeah, when it comes to legacy and what we pick for career, I honestly feel like I had a few moments like Lou has had and like Heather has had where we've all like shared that God has spoken to us in certain seasons and repositioned us in front of different people. So one of the topics of our conversation, the three of us recently, has been we're all with this pandemic, right? We're all in this phase of new things and new ways and taking inventory of like the people and kind of surveying the land of like what's happening and what's still going to be around. You know, mm-hmm. during and after the pandemic, what kind of businesses are still going to be going strong?
And we've been able to talk about how we're representing three different generations. We've got our 30s,
and our
40s, and 50s.
Yeah.
And sometimes in friendship, you're looking at, they say to always be around people
seasons.
That are different than you,
mm-hmm.
that might have more wisdom than you, because
right.
that's how you
mm-hmm.
grow. And each of us have maybe a little spout of wisdom in a certain area that the other one doesn't. So we're able to share that with each other. But to have such different generations, too, in a friendship is unique. And I love that.
Yeah.
I love
and
that a lot.
And it's true.
Yeah.
Being on the oldest end of that, I think it's important. Because the older you get, the more you start to get a little concerned that you might be becoming irrelevant in it, you know, some type of a way. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And then when you're able to share some things with a younger person and you get a little spark of, oh, you know, I helped share some wisdom with them.
Yeah, and motherhood,
it's,
too.
We've got
the younger, Leah's got Presley
Makes
Joy, who
good.
Is, how old is she, 8?
She's 5.
Oh, my gosh.
She's 5.
I thought she was 8 because she's so smart.
She's small.
She's 5. I've got my teenagers. Lou has children that are grown, married, having babies of their own.
Yeah.
And so we're each able to kind of have a different season of our life to share in our friendship and to really, truly be authentic. And that's my biggest encouragement for people is with mental health. You have to be real with yourself first. Mm-hmm. Know and check yourself every day. How am I feeling? And then with friendships, you're not going to get anywhere past surface level until you're authentic and show each other your faults and your weaknesses and your blessings and the gifts that you're able to help other people with. And what I love about Leah and Lou are they do help people. You know, Lou helps people look beautiful on the outside, and she helps people grow and shine with their careers. Mm-hmm. Leah helps people find homes. She was my realtor. Mm-hmm. I bought my very first home.
To be mm-hmm. your realtor.
My very first home, and I was not looking to buy a home. Yeah. I was trying to find a rental, and I called Leah, and I was like, so God told me that I was supposed to buy a house this year, and I think I found one, so let's go see it.
There you go.
And it literally happened within like a week.
So, Leah, so you're here now. You got your real estate agent hat on now. What's the real estate market? How's things going out there?
It is hot, like sizzling.
Yeah,
no kidding. Out in this market right now. And y'all, really what it is a market where I think because the pandemic has also started to shift everybody in their homes from quarantine, of course, but people in their spaces, I think, really began to feel like, I don't know if I want to stay here, or, you know, when they were there this year, or wow, I can actually work from home full time. Maybe I want a space or upsize or downsize that I can actually like have a home office, or, you know, wow, there's toilet paper selling out at the grocery stores, and oh my goodness, maybe some food. There's like moments where you'd go to the grocery store in the beginning of the pandemic, and like there would be signs of a soon to come food desert or famine, honestly, if we weren't getting the right shipments in. So there was like sections of the grocery store with sold out shelves.
Yeah. Yes.
So people started gardening and wanting to eat off their land too, Mike.
Yeah.
So, I mean, these
buying
girls
chickens
are always having their wheels turning. So like talking about random. And we talk every week, Mike, friends. We talk every week. She and I were murmuring about this summer. We were like, can we just pinch ourselves that we get to have a friend like her that's like so full of adventure? Because we got to walk her farm together and just be like one with the animals.
Right.
And her, of course. But she, one day we were just on social media, and one day she just shows up with, she's got this goats on the, goats in your pictures on your feet. In other words,
like,
she did
what?
Not tell
what?
Us, Mike.
What?
Okay, that, like, so she was going to become this farmer.
Yeah, when were you guys going popping champagne bottles a couple weeks ago? There's a video.
Oh, yeah.
You know, that was New Beginnings. It was New Beginnings. You know, people are very well aware that I've gone through domestic violence, survivor of domestic violence. I obviously had to disconnect myself and file for divorce from that person. So that was also celebrating that I was able to receive a finalized divorce, that I'm going into New Beginnings with Heather Marie Speaks, closed doors and open doors, just celebrating really life. And it's important to do that with friends that are they're celebrating with you for sure.
Yep.
Ladies and gentlemen, the time 2:29. Heather Marie Speaks is here. She's here with Leah Coleman, Lou Stevens. We're here talking. We got to go away for a moment. We'll be back, and you know, we'll be back shortly.
Yeah.
Henley Watches is the must-have, stylish, comfortable, and versatile timepiece for the person who values quality. Henley offers sophisticated, modern designs that inspires confidence and generates conversation. Contact us today for the On the Mic with Mike promo. Henley Watches is the official timepiece of Mike King Biz and On the Mic with Mike. Connect with us at HenleyWatches.com today.
H-A-N-D-L-E-Y, HenleyWatches.com.
This is Candace Dion. Make sure you tune into Discussions with Dion every Monday at 2 p.m., where we talk inspiration, motivation, natural health, fitness, and life. You can find me at Dancing with Dion, D-I-O-N, dancingwithdion.com, and Candace Dion on Facebook and Instagram.
Talking about being your best, Discussions with Dion, Mondays on The Mic with Mike, here on WJFN 92.7 and 100.5 FM.
Welcome to Miss Girlie's, conveniently located at 4809 Parker Street in the heart of Fulton. We take food back to the basics, just like our grandmother, Girlie Frances Crump, used to do it, the way we've always done it. So grab your family, grab your friends, and come taste a little bit of home. Open for business 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. Tuesday through Saturday.
This is Mike King Biz of On the Mic with Mike, and I'm here with the Dope Soap Lady.
Yes, it's the Dope Soap Lady. I got them sales. I got that BOGO, buy one, get one. Come and get this dope soap today.
How do people find the Dope Soap Lady?
GinasLove.com.
I enjoy listening to On the Mic with Mike every day at 1 p.m.
That's what I do!
Hey everybody, welcome back. It's Heather Marie Van Cleve with Heather Marie Speaks radio show on the mic with Mike on WJFN radio. And I am here with two of my best friends, Leah and Lou. And just wanted to shout out real quick to today's sponsor. Ozzy Bloss of Bloss Couture is today's radio show sponsor.
Wait a second, what is it? Ozzy Bloss
of Bloss? Ozzy Bloss of Bloss Couture. Whoa. And he has been one of the designers from the RVA Fashion Week show this past year, the fall fashion show. He is an amazing designer. Stay tuned because you know that I am a fashion-infused mental health advocate. And tonight there is going to be a photo shoot with one of Ozzy's designer pieces, which is custom, one of a kind, and it is called the Christmas Dress. This is something that no one has seen before, and it is pretty amazing. So you know that those fire photos McKinley took, he's going to take some more.
Yeah, I mean, yeah, and they will show up with you. I mean, you do have some of the coolest friends.
Thank you.
The videos and the things. You make the whole idea of mental health, dressing it up more, I guess, easier for people to deal with.
Yeah.
And
yeah.
So how you told me how you went about that, because actually, how do you tie those two together? It makes the conversation easier. I'm not saying it's better. Go ahead.
There's a stigma on mental health, and people know it. We're trying to remove that stigma, and being able to talk about it with infusing some fashion in there is something that is an easier way to discuss it. And my two best friends are so fashionable. I love that they have their own sense of style. Leah shows up sometimes in these pieces, and I'm like, where did you get that?
Well, this is a fashion week designer piece, actually, okay. From Chanel Green, stitched by Chanel.
Love Chanel. Hey,
she custom dressed this for me last year. Remember when we went to the Christine Kane conference?
Yeah.
So she dressed me in this last year, and being the way it's kind of like more like a cape, I like it because it doesn't, like, hold my arms down like a thick jacket in the winter or fall. You can even do...
There's tips out there. There's hope
don't
for
want to be confined.
Us.
Yes!
Yes.
And you can even do it, like, with summer.
Yeah.
And keep your sleeves open.
So. Well, you're always rocking fashion.
Yes,
I love
she
that.
Is.
Thank you.
Lou also is a fashionista. She is one of those that finds these amazing pieces and rocks them. And there's been many a times where we both have had
the
a piece
thing.
On and we're like, I have that. And she's like, I know I have it too because I'll
we've
share a little secret.
Up, we've never shown up the same day in the same thing though, have we?
Never shown up the same day, but I'll share a little secret because a lot of people don't realize that some of my finds that I get are from one of my favorite shops. It's called the GW, and that is the Goodwill. Mm-hmm. I have found some amazing pieces there. I am not ashamed to shop there.
The GW. I'm on the edge of the seat saying, where's that?
I know, right? And then the other place that I found some really amazing things is at Ross.
It's
I found some really cool places. And, you know, I'm one of those that will mix a designer piece with something that I got from the GW all day long. Mm-hmm. And you rock it because part of it is you're expressing yourself on the outside with your personality, but we want to make sure that you feel good on the inside with your heart and loving yourself too. So when you're able to combine that together, you're balanced in your mind, body, and soul, you can really truly shine. And so that's what I try to encourage people. But I love these two sisters of mine because they do that. They they take care of the mind, body, and soul.
And we love red lipstick. Can we please talk about the power color of red lipstick?
Yeah.
Okay, and that was actually how I met you at first at her venue. Okay, y'all, this is funny. We were walking in, Heather was doing a tour, and I was just friend coming to check it out, and she walked me past Lou, who had set up with your makeup team, right? It was like a nice open house featuring her wedding venue. Lou looks at me and she hardly even says hi or anything. She goes, I just have got to tell you, your makeup looks so good. Do you want a job?
Exactly. Oh, I was trying to improve.
I love it.
I said, I'm still trying to recruit her, do it myself.
Yeah.
It was just so complimentary and flattering, honestly, because I'm not in the beauty industry, so
but you have such a great sense of style.
Thank you. I do have well, one of my best friends from growing up. Her name is Mari Kneebone from Parlor Salon.
Oh,
if you all know her, she was my best friend. Yeah, she was my best friend in high school and college. We are still really good friends. We don't get a chance to see one another as often because she's very influential in her space too. As we, you know, aged and all kind of got to adulting, but gosh, we're girls that are not scared, Mike, to talk about the edgy stuff.
Yes,
we got some edgy friends
again. Authentic, real. This is the friendship here. So I want to make sure before we get off the air too that we have a ways for people to be able to contact you. So Lou Stevens Glam Squad is on site location for hair and makeup for brides and for special events, right? So how can they find you?
I mean, on social media,
but at
Squad. A lady was here the other time, and somebody said, "How can I find you?" And she dropped one thing: just Google me. When you get to a certain level, that's just true. Just Google me.
Just Google me. Okay. Exactly. Yeah. Lou Stevens.
She's all over the place. And Leah, how do they find you?
You could just Google me too, Leah Coleman. but do RVA because there's a really sweet author, young author. Yeah. There's another Leah Coleman in the world.
Oh.
So I feel like, you know, it's kind of cool that I get to cross her stuff every once in a while. But, LeahColeman.co is also an easy spot to find.
Real estate?
Yeah, and I'm a renovating realtor.
What's that?
Which is a little different because realtors all practice a lot of buy and sell stuff. But I renovate and fix and resell. So a lot of people are more used to the term flipping.
Okay. She's so gifted at it.
So, and I love to decorate and love to make a space like just super affordable and cozy and stylish and on a budget. Like that's definitely my gift. In fact, we talked about if I could write a book one day, we should call it Bad and Bougie on a Budget.
Y'all should come out with Bad and Bougie on a Budget.
Bad and Bougie on a Budget.
That describes all of us.
Yeah, pretty much.
Warrior women.
Okay, then we got Lily and Lulu.
There you go.
And and we've got our Heather who will make sure that all the words and everything is straight.
Also, you get you one last time about the pest control, you know.
Thank you, Mike.
Okay, thanks.
Shout out to Chuck, Charles Coleman. So integratedpestva.com. He does eco-friendly pest control, which is just really geared for chemical-conscious people.
Okay.
In your environment, both interior
and he'll
exterior.
Come and chase snakes out of your yard.
Yeah, he's or a wild man. There's definitely a gift for people that have, like, the guts to do some of the stuff that he does. I mean, even watching some of his videos while I'm at work and he's at work and he's like on top of roofs
and
taking out with, you know, his mask and his wand, massive bee nest or like getting a raccoon. I mean,
I got to tell you, I called her one day and I said, I have a farm, but I don't do reptiles. I don't do snakes. I don't like them. They remind me of the devil. I don't want them anywhere near me. So I called her and I was like, sister friend, I'm going to need you to get your husband over here ASAP, please. I've got a humongous snake that has just tried to eat one of my chickens. I'm sure it's probably a friendly snake, but he does not belong on my farm. And so this man showed up with a machete and was not afraid and was like, show me where the snake is.
Oh my God.
Yeah. Real
bad. We call him a mass murderer, but like the thing
he was not
really
afraid.
Don't want
near
you.
A real man.
Space, so.
Yeah, that is manly very strategic. Man. Yeah.
He will come and take care of business.
Well,
so.
And he has, one thing I did learn about him, and this was kind of cool, but I'm going to tie this to our friendship too, because we all have stamps on our passports. We've all traveled the world a little bit. But Chuck speaks like four languages, y'all.
Yeah.
And that's one of the things that was always so impressive and hot about my hubby. Okay, please.
And holding a big old machete while he speaks to you in foreign languages.
But he can speak Spanish, Mandarin,
Chuck also looks like Biggie Smalls for a while. I called him.
Oh, that's hilarious.
I'll say this time for a break. We got the man with the machete speaking four languages.
We should
and
have.
She's like, oh, my husband's hot.
Hold on.
This is a business show.
I got to give you the visual, though, because these two were like Biggie Smalls and Faith Evans. Chuck, when I first met him, looked like Notorious B.I.G. Leah says to me, she's like, to all the ladies in the place with style and grace. And that became our, like, slang.
Okay, I'm done.
Okay, I bought the t-shirt. I bought the t-shirt this past year. Somebody made it on Amazon.
That's
and
awesome.
I bought it. I'm like, I have to have this.
To all the ladies, line.
I mean,
that's it.
And I'll never forget where I asked my husband about a machete. Like, where would you use this? Why? Like, what? And he was just like, I mean, these are the things that you use in the Serengeti. Like, you, when you go out in the wild, yeah, in the desert, in he's Africa. Prepared. Yeah.
And he's ready.
He did a little, we've all kind of also done mission work. So we have, like, common thread interests that are, like, so unique in our friendship.
Well, it's good, ladies. I got to talk to the military man.
Yes.
So he's all dressed up. We got to give him Sergeant First Class Castillo, his Army recruiter. He's here.
This has been so fun, though.
This has been
ladies,
fun.
Thank you so much thank for joining you. Me today. Again, you guys can find me at HeatherMarieSpeaks.com, on Instagram at HeatherMarieSpeaks, and on Facebook at the HeatherMarieSpeaks page. Thanks,
alrighty.
Guys.
Like, thanks, lady, thank for coming you. In. Appreciate it. Up next, ladies and gentlemen, we have Sergeant Castillo, Army recruiter. Also, some big things dropping with me. I'm on a project with Sarah Ellen Bagby. And that more about that will be coming out soon. I want to mic with Mike, the best business radio show in the area. Thanks for tuning in. Up next, we got Sarge, who's here to tell us all the great things about Uncle Sam. I gave him the best that I had. This is all that's left. You're talking to you guys, so we'll talk to you in a minute.
Do you want a crystal clear picture of your finances? Dial 804-601-0532 and schedule your free financial review with Crystal Clear Financial Solutions. Find us online at crystalclearfinancialsolutions.com.
Welcome to the SBA Weekly Business Tip. I'm Martin Short with the U.S. Small Business Administration, Virginia Richmond District Office. You need to make a strategic decision about which state, city, and neighborhood you choose to start your business. Your business location determines the taxes, zoning laws, and regulations. Research the best place. You need to register your business, pay taxes, obtain licenses and permits from your location of choice. Location should depend on your target market, partners, and preferences. To learn more, visit us at sba.gov/VA. We're here to help you start, grow, expand, or recover.
Mike King here, host of On the Mic with Mike.
And I'm Paula, the host of Modern Love.
You can find us together 1:30 on Fridays as we
talk about all things love. We talk about how modern matchmaking works. We talk about getting into a healthy, real relationship.
Stop swiping left and right and learn how to find love in all the right places. Paula Pardell, Modern Love Friday, exclusively on the Mic with Mike and only heard here on WJFN 92.7 and 100.5 FM.
Welcome to Miss Girlie's, conveniently located at 4809 Parker Street in the heart of Fulton. We take food back to the basics, just like our grandmother, Girlie Frances Crump, used to do it, the way we've always done it. So grab your family, grab your friends, and come taste a little bit of home. Open for business 11 a.m. to 6 p.m. Tuesday through Saturday.
Hey guys, this is Robin with DB Arcade Commercial Video and Photography. If you need creative visual content for social media or traditional advertising, then we're the team you want working for you. We create custom ROI-driven videos and photography for your business, no matter what products or services you offer. We've worked with local newspapers, gyms, real estate agents, financial advisors, clothing companies, restaurants, and more. For more information, check us out on our website at db-arcade.com.
This is Candace Dion. Make sure you tune into Discussions with Dion every Monday at 2 p.m., where we talk inspiration, motivation, natural health, fitness, and life. You can find me at Dancing with Dion, D-I-O-N, dancingwithdion.com, and Candace Dion on Facebook and Instagram.
Talking about being your best, Discussions with Dion, Mondays on the Mic with Mike, here on WJFN 92.7 and 100.5 FM.
This is Mike King Biz of On the Mic with Mike, and I'm here with the Dope Soap Lady.
Yes, it's the Dope Soap Lady. I got them sales. I got that BOGO, buy one, get one. Come and get this dope soap today.
How do people find the Dope Soap Lady?
GinasLove.com.
Hey, it's Shannon Lilly, and I'll be on the mic with Mike this Friday. Tune into 100.5 and 92.7 FM.
Hey, this is Mike King, the host of On the Mic with Mike, and I'm here with
Chef Robin Carter.
Chef, I hear you got some exciting news for our listeners.
Yes, available on our website right now at carolinagirlcatering.com is the holiday menu. It's available for pre-order until the 22nd, and then pickups and deliveries will be available the 23rd through the 25th.
And what can people expect on the holiday menu?
We have vegan options as well as non-vegan options. Everything on there is a side. We have potatoes, we have vegetable sides, charcuterie spreads along with boards available on there as well, handmade pies. CarolinaGirlCatering.com.
Mike King isn't a businessman. He's a businessman with his own talk show. On the Mic with Mike, the best business radio program in the game.
Gentlemen, welcome back. On the Mic with Mike, the best business radio program in the area. I'm your host, Mike King. It's my honor now to talk to Sergeant First Class Castillo, Uncle Sam's Army. The man is dressed impeccably. He got his dress blues on. He is here talking about recruitment, the military, and the impact. It had a big impact on my life. Met my wife there 40 years ago, Fort Riley, Kansas. Shout out to Uncle Sam's Army. Whoa. Welcome to the program.
Thank you for the invite.
Alrighty, so now you reached out. You're a recruiter out there. Talk a little bit about how you got to where you are and the opportunities that the military offers even now during these times.
Well, let me introduce myself. My name is Sergeant Castillo. I am an Army recruiter. I'm new in this area in Richmond. Before I came here, I was recruiting in Orlando, Florida, and I was there for about 5 years. And I've been recruiting through the East Coast of the U.S., and this should be my final stop before I retire, so I'm glad to be here. Thank you for the invite.
All righty. Now, see, you reached out.
Yes, I did.
And see, you're making things happen. Talk a little bit about the journey, getting to be a recruiter. Where are you from originally?
Originally, I am from Nicaragua.
Okay.
That's in Central America. I will tell you a little bit of my story, my personal story on how I ended up here. Okay. But I did reach out to you because... like you told me, I'm a hustler.
Well, they're hustling. You're out there selling. You're selling the dream.
I am a hustler, so I have to think outside the box. I have to see what works, what's not working. But the biggest thing is exposure. I have to expose myself to the community. Obviously, you know, whatever's going on right now, mm-hmm. We don't have the access to the schools or to the public because there's nothing going on. There's not events going on. Nothing's going on. So this is the best route for me to expose myself and talk to your audience about the Army.
Now, the thing is, so like I said, I live right up the street from the recruiting station. Right. And I would go, and we're out right there by Chuck E. Cheese. And so where are you located? You got to let people know.
We are located at 9062 West Broad Street.
I used to see the recruiters going in there. I see people running PT, doing all those things. And there were times I'd be like, I'd like to talk to one of them on about what I do with radio.
Right.
And all of a sudden, a Sergeant Castillo pops up and says, hey, what's up?
I'm here.
You're here. Talk a little bit about what you're looking for. What's it like for people in the military, like recruiting now? Like, what does the Army have to offer? And it's a dream.
Right.
You know, I did my time. I hated the duty station where I was at until I left.
Yep.
And then you start thinking, God, I used to love that place.
Let's do this. Why got you? Why did you join the Army?
I saw people with cool things. I always wanted. I knew I was going to go in, and I joined in Philly. So I saw the recruiter.
Philly? Oh yeah, where at?
On Broad Street, right across from the AFE station.
Okay.
Right across from the AFE station. My wife joined in Times Square.
This is downtown, right, in Philly?
Mm-hmm.
Okay, yeah, because I was stationed in the other office in Cotman Avenue in Philly.
Got you out on Cotman Avenue.
Yeah, that's where I was.
So right across the street from the AFE station is the office right on the corner.
Right.
I joined, and the years went by, and next thing you know, so I meet up with my wife. It gave me an opportunity to see the world.
Right.
It offers opportunities. Talk a little bit about what the opportunities are for young people now.
Well, the biggest the opportunities have never changed. It's just what changes is the amount of money. Basically, a lot of people join for different reasons. Most of the kids right now, they're joining because they need money for college. Okay. They need help to pay for their education. Whether they join active duty or reserve, they will receive the same benefits. Some people join because they need a job. They need a career. The Army will train you a specific field so you can do it in the Army. And then once you get out of the Army, you can use that in the civilian side. For example, if you have an extract technician, just think about how long it takes an extract technician to go to school in the civilian side and pay for it. And you still have to get a job to pay for that. So in the Army, not only do we train you as an extract technician, we pay you while you're training and you have no bills. So that's a plus as far as benefit goes.
Seeing the world and instilling discipline and all those things, it opens the world up to you to see things you've never seen and to meet people. Let's talk a little about the relationships part. Now, see, we can sit here and talk military
right.
all day. Hey, I was stationed here and all those things. They become a big part of your life.
Right. When I joined the Army, before I joined the Army, I never thought I was going to be able to visit all these places that I have visited. For example, Korea, South Korea. I was stationed there.
I was in Wijambu.
Wijambu? Camp Casey.
Yeah.
So I was there. I was able to visit Korea. I don't think I would ever visit Korea as a civilian. I'm telling you, probably I would have never gone to Korea. But I did, and I loved the place. I loved the culture. I liked to learn about different cultures, and that was a great opportunity for me to learn about Korea, about the Koreans and their culture, their food, especially their food.
I know.
Yeah.
Okay, so here, times 252, Sergeant First Class Castillo, Uncle Sam's best. He's the best recruiter because he's sitting here with us right now. I'd like to thank you for coming in. What is the okay, so parents are out there. They have a young person that's out there thinking, I want to join the military. And now, what's the process now?
Okay, I'm going to give you the process in the shortest version that I have.
Okay.
Obviously, step number one, you go and you talk to a recruiter. The recruiter is your number one source of information on how you or your son can join the Army. Once again, the recruiter, because I know some people that go, they talk to Uncle Bob,
yeah,
who served 20 years ago.
Times have changed.
Right, and he was never a recruiter, so he doesn't know the process, because this happened to me before I became a recruiter. I was just a soldier, and I had no idea how the process of recruiting works. Now I understand it, obviously. But that's the first thing you got to do. You got to find a recruiter. Once you find this recruiter or the recruiting office, go and talk to the recruiters. Ask all the questions you need to ask. Don't be afraid also to especially now with the technology, you get on the computer and you just browse or try to find information about the Army recruiting. All that information is already online. So the recruiter, what we do is we'll talk to you about the process and we'll process you into enlisting. But all the information basically is in your hand on a laptop and a computer. So first thing you do, you talk to a recruiter. Once we're going to ask you a whole bunch of questions to see if you meet the minimum criteria, because not everybody meets the minimum criteria.
Okay, let's talk. What's the minimum criteria now? Because those change at times.
Oh, yes.
What's the minimum criteria now?
Age. You have to be at least 17 to 35. If you are 17 or your child is 17, they need parental consent. Both parents have to sign, or whoever has full custody of that child can sign for them to enlist.
Okay.
Okay. If you are, now going back to the other side, if you are 35, you have to be in basic training before you turn 35.
Okay.
Next, education. You have to be in high school, a junior or a senior, or have graduated from school. Sometimes we do exceptions with GED, but that's not always the case. That comes and goes whenever.
That is true. If we need people, that kind of comes and goes.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, so the process, now a person joins, they sign up, and then they go away to basic training. How long is basic training?
Basic training is 9 weeks, and then that's phase one. Phase one is basic training. Second phase is job training. Basically, that time is determined by the job that you chose. For example, if you are interested in being a medic, a combat medic in the Army, you're going to spend four months in Fort Eustis, Texas.
Fort Sam.
Fort Sam, Antonio, Texas.
Some of the best times down at Fort Sam. I was a medic.
I love the river.
I know.
You are a medic?
Yeah, I was a medic.
So you know what I'm talking about.
Yes, I do.
Okay.
I started as 91 Bang.
Okay.
So, yeah, my wife was a 91 Charlie. So yeah, Fort Sam, the Riverwalk. Yes.
Beautiful yes, place. Yeah, beautiful place. So you go to Fort Sam, 4 months, 2 months of basic training, 4 months of job training. Then if you are active duty, you're going to be assigned a duty station anywhere in the United States or overseas. Overseas meaning Germany, South Korea, Japan, many places. If you are a reservist, you complete your training and you come back home and you report to your unit, to your local unit, 1 week in a month, one Saturday and one Sunday a month for the next 6 years.
Okay. Pay-wise now, where are we at now? So when people are looking, what's
entry-level pay-wise is roughly about $1,700 a month, okay? That does not include your housing, your meals, obviously college. So that's an extra. For those people that are married or have kids, full coverage for medical. So your whole family gets full benefits from medical.
And so I'm blasting through these questions now, ladies and gentlemen. Sergeant First Class Castillo is here. How can people find you?
You can reach me at my phone number. It's area code 443-306-0948. Once again, 443-306-0948.
Enlistment terms, how long?
The minimum right now is 3 years. The max is 6 years.
Right from the get-go?
Yes.
A person can sign up and now they want to do six right off the bat?
Some jobs require you to do them.
Oh, really?
Because the longer the training is, you know, how you're going to pick a job that training, you're going to spend 12 months training and then you're going to turn around and do 2 more years?
No, you got to do more time.
Yeah. So.
Best duty station that you had been to?
Wow. Well, I don't know about best. I've been in different places. Each place has their own pros and cons. I would like to say Korea, because in Korea, I did a lot of stuff. Stuff that I never did in the U.S. For example, snowboarding, rock climbing. I did so many stuff in Korea, but at the same time, I work a lot.
It is, and it opens the world up to you to see things that you had never seen before, to meet people that you had never met in your lifetime. Worst duty station?
The one we're talking about, Kansas. Kansas, I mean, we were always on the field. Fort Riley, Kansas, we were always on the field.
Yeah,
extremely cold. I'm not from the cold weather. When I joined the Army in Miami, Florida, you know, they stuck me in Kansas. I never seen the snow. To me, I was shocked.
Ladies and gentlemen, Sergeant First Class Castillo, I joined in Pennsylvania, and I went to Fort Leonard Wood, Missouri. I didn't know where Missouri was at. And I went in January. I'm like, oh, it's kind of like down south.
Yeah.
No, it wasn't.
No.
It was not. All right, Sarge, so people can find you one last time.
They can also.
We want people to find you.
You can find me on social media, SFC Castillo, C-A-S-T-I-L-O. That's on Instagram. Or in Facebook, believe me, you find me Castillo, you'll find me there because I post that everywhere.
Yeah, he is. Ladies and gentlemen, this man is out there hustling, and let me tell you, the being in the Army changed my life. It really did. I thanked him for being a matchmaker to me and meeting my wife there in Fort Riley, Kansas, 1982. So, you know, the best business program. If you have people who are looking at the military as an option, make sure you check out Sergeant Castillo. He's out there really making a difference. It will change your life. Today is Thursday. Tomorrow we have Paula Pardell with Modern Love. She's going to be in talking about how to help your life left and right, swiping, stopping that craziness. We also had the Swagger Studio brought to you by Brown Baylor there. And tomorrow we're going to have Shannon Lilly, who is a morning reporter for CBS 6. She's also a singer-songwriter. So tune in. Thanks to all the guests today, Lou Stevens, Leah Coleman, as well as we had Jerome Olivier. I see Heather Marie Speaks pulling out of the parking lot. Thanks, everyone, for tuning in.
We got a minute? We got
a hurry, Sarge.
Give me a minute.
Wait, do we have a minute?
I would like to present Mike with this certificate of appreciation for letting us in the air. This is
all right. Appreciate it. Thank you. There you go, ladies and gentlemen. Thanks now. Take care.
Breaking news this hour from townhall.com. I'm John Scott. FDA Commissioner Stephen Hahn says today's meeting of the administration's vaccine advisory panel is an important day for all of America.
He told NBC's Today,
"It is not just a formality. We take this very seriously in terms of having the transparency around our process. It's why we have outside experts, because issues, medical issues, scientific issues could be raised that need to be addressed."
He says the FDA would include recommendations in any emergency use authorization about who should not get the vaccine also.